So welcome back, folks, to episode number 24 of The Long Dark, A Noob's Journey. So we left off in the last video. We had a nice little view. It was the sunrise coming over, and all I did was stop the video, and then I rested for an hour, or just passed time for an hour to get a save point. And we're going to continue on with our journey. So if you are watching this, then it means that I was able to steal my wife's laptop to download the videos and upload them to YouTube. Otherwise, I would not be able to do it. Okay, there's our cave. Or there's a cave. I was trying something new, and I found that my old laptop had some editing software on it. So it took a little bit of effort, but I got the video the way I wanted it. I added a front screen and a back screen. Was able to actually shorten it a little bit. And I even put a little video in the middle of it. Because at one point in the last video, or in one of my previous videos, I talked about the snow shelter and how you should be able to tell how what condition it was in. And going back and looking at that video, what I did notice was in the upper left-hand corner, it actually showed the condition of the snow shelter. So I decided to do a little bit of editing, and I took that video and just cut out a little section and added it in the middle of video 21, which I have not posted yet, and saved it all up and had looking, for me, it looked really good. Thought, wow, I'm kind of on the professional level here. And then when I tried to save it, I was sitting there and for some reason my computer just shut down. So I restarted the laptop and it did not save any of my work, so I knew what I was wanting to do, so I did it again. It's like a dead person up there. And while I was trying to save it again, I noticed that there was a burning smell. And then the screen on my computer started going all kinds of different colors and started crackling and making all kinds of noises, and I immediately unplugged it, pulled the battery out of it, and now I have no laptop because it fried the entire thing. Turn my game volume down here a little bit. So I have no laptop to download the videos from Twitch or to put them up on YouTube. And hopefully, if I catch my wife not looking, I'm going to steal her laptop for a few minutes and try that. So hopefully I can get my latest videos, get them uploaded. And if you never see any videos past video number, this is 24, then that means she caught me and I am no longer amongst the living.
I'm starving.
She really likes her laptop. But we're going to give it a try. Because I found that I'm actually enjoying this a little bit. And I've also found that this is much, much harder than I thought. Editing videos. And I have a newfound respect for those that do it a lot. And put out multiple videos. Now, because there is a lot of work involved. Okay, and I'm having to click my mic on and off because I've also, along with the problems with my laptop, I also ended up with food poisoning a couple of days ago. Yay! I ate some tuna in a package, tuna salad. And it ended up giving me food poisoning. What's that? Oh, that's a wolf. So I am trying to get over the food poisoning. And it's funny because in the game here it talks about, oh, you get food poisoning and you rest for 10 hours and you're good to go afterwards after taking antibiotics. Yeah, that's not how the real world works. It's been a couple of days and I am still feeling like crap. If I was actually in this game, I would still be in bed. So another spectacular view from the makers of The Long Dark. They have put a lot of time and effort in this game. And I see why a lot of people end up learning these maps really good. Because it's a very fun game to play. So you want to keep playing it over and over and over. And not a lot of new maps get added. Because it seems like they're taking their time and making sure that the maps that are added are really good maps and good quality. And I appreciate that in a game. As I said, I'm not much of a first-person shooter gamer. Some of the games I do play, like the Forza games, because I like racing in cars. In the later versions of the game, like Forza 7 I'm currently playing, a lot of the details are good, but they're not great. And it seems like they could have spent a little more time on the details. I didn't map over here. Also haven't eaten. Let's eat one of these. And what I'm going to do is explore up in this area for a little bit. And then I think in game day tomorrow, we are going to head back down because there's a whole lot of this map that I haven't seen yet. I think if I go here, I can get all of this. Okay, so our mysterious signal fire, and if we look, there's still a lot of this map that I haven't been on yet. I've been on pretty much all of this and mapped it. Because that just runs around the cliff. But I do know that it comes way out here. And I want to get all of that mapped. And I know you can't use the maps that, like on this run, I can't use a map that I make here on another gameplay, I don't believe. It's something I have to look into. But if I make maps, then I'm more likely to remember where everything is generalized term. I won't remember exactly where everything is because I haven't played it much. But I'll know generally where I'm going. So that is my goal. Learn the maps. Okay, and this is where we... This is the place I was looking for in the previous episode, but I couldn't find where I left the rifle. It turns out I was in a whole different section. Let me look at my map here. Bring up the map. And wide zoom. And there's my wolf carcass. So I did go up in here. So I think I've mapped up here about everything I can except for here. And I think that's about where I'm at now. So let's... Let's walk down here and take a look. I'm not going that way. So it appears there's only one wolf up here. I don't know if you can get up there. Come over here and do a map. And then I believe we're going to have to decide what we're going to... Oh, you can get down here. Have I been down here? I don't know. Let's check it out. There was one place I climbed, but it had a dead body in it. And I could see the dead body from the top. Okay, so it shows where I'm at. Is that, oh, road six. So that's where I came down. Mysterious signal fires right over here. So this is the area that I need to map. So it would be over here. Go ahead and keep our well-fed bonus up. And I believe I'm going to collect more cattails. Also have the wolf over here. But I'm also getting tired. And I have no coffee. Climb down here.
I need to eat some.
So I don't think I've been down here before. Seems like it's a whole nother area down here. It's not the bottom, because the bottom's over there. So I am getting tired. But I think I'm going to check it out anyway. I think the signal fires a little bit above us. This, if I can find a path down from here, that means I won't have to make two trips on the rope. Let's do a map and it'll pinpoint. What I think, if you do a map, even if you've done that in the area, if you've done a map of that area, it will pinpoint right where you're at. Okay, so the signal fire would be above us. Over there. And I believe what I'm going to do, because I have to get some food. Oh, crap. I have to get me some food. And there's a way down that way. And I'll probably sleep through the night, and then in the morning come straight over here and explore that area, because I want to get back up this before I'm overburdened. I believe I come over here and make a left. I don't think I have to climb anymore. Oh, I do have to climb. It would be interesting to actually spawn in this area to see what you could do. If you could find a rifle or a pistol right off and you're able to hunt, clothing would be an issue. But I think this area would be, as long as you can hunt and you can get some decent clothing, a person could survive. If you ran to the, figured out where the signal fire was and went to there first, there seemed to be a lot of supplies there. I think you would be okay. I went the wrong way, didn't I? Yeah, I think we went the wrong way. Oh, now she's getting real tired. So let's eat over here. It's quicker. Some water in us. We'll reduce our weight a little bit. Let's see. 14 sticks. No, she's really tired. I may just have to go back to our cave and eat the food that I have there. Which will mean that the wolf will probably despawn. That's okay. Let's go this way. For sure shooting if I... Wait a minute. I think I need to go up the other side because I think that's a longer way around. If I go ahead and collect the wolf meat now, I didn't cross the log to get down here. But I do think there was another way up over here. Yeah. I'm going to go up around this way. Replenish my supply a little bit. Okay, I believe that is the light. So since we're almost there, yep, mammoth light. Go ahead and collect cattails. But I'm not sure, I don't remember. It's been a couple of days since I've played. And I don't remember what all food I had left over here. So it should be up here near the falls. I had somebody leave me a comment from the first video that I did saying that one of the things that I should do was turn the game volume down a little bit. So I have done that for this video. So this is number 24. I turned it down one notch. And I will go back and review it and see how it is. The video that they left a comment on, I believe in the next video, or the one after that, I did turn the volume down once. So I will go back and look at it. And see if I need to turn it down again. Did I drop that?
I could use this.
Okay, so I too. I did not leave food here. Yeah, I could not remember if I left food or not. Temperature in here is a little bit wet. 66 degrees. So I should not need a fire for the night. My water supply is a little bit low, so I think I'm going to go ahead and build a fire. Got plenty of sticks on me. For nothing else, to build up my fire starting ability. Let me just cat to head. Because I've been building fires, but I haven't been building, I've been building long laps. And I think to get my fire starting up a little bit higher, I need to do more fires that don't last as long. Gives me 5 hours and 41 minutes. I know it says it up here in the top left, but I have my Twitch bar in the top left and that covers it up. Let's make up some water. We still have daylight, but I'm going to go ahead and drop my bedroll. And go ahead and eat. I'm just going to eat up all these. It should get me through the night, and I saw a lot of them over there, and I can pick those up in the morning. Because if that, where I was just at, and I said I was going to come back to in the morning, if that actually leads down, then I want to make sure that I have all my stuff with me. So I don't have to run back up here and pick up stuff and then go back down there again. Did I have... I have 24 and I also have these, so... go over here to crafting. And we will go ahead and prepare those up. I did see some, yep, I got just enough for that. I did hear somebody say that, another gamer, that every time you cook up a tea, you actually get points toward your cooking skill. Okay. I'm going to take that one. Which water does that give me? I know I just set it up there, but let's see. Alright. Alright, button. Oh, 1.3 gallon, okay, so that'd be enough. Let's go ahead and cook up rose hips. And cook up the reishi mushrooms. What's the temperature getting in here? Feels like 100. But again, I'm next to the fire, which is 54, so it would be 40 something degrees in here without the fire. And in my sleeping bag, it should raise the temperature up. So I'm going to have 4 hours. I'm trying to think. I don't believe I left any wood sitting here. See how cold it is out here. Okay, a little bit cold. Take 18 minutes, break those down, and what I'm going to do is just pile all the wood on the fire. And then that will get me some sleep. And our weight is 77, but I do want to carry... See, I won't carry all those sticks with me. I do want to take my hides back with me. I'm going to look real quick and see if there's anything I can get rid of. Get rid of that. So I've got the two books, but I have not researched them yet. I'm definitely not getting rid of those. I think we might just have to live with being heavy. In my test playthrough, I didn't realize that you have to be careful around the fire because if you step in it, you'll get yourself burned. Looks like it's clearing up a little bit out there. So I ended up burning myself because I walked over the campfire by accident. I can always pick up more sticks. And I just burned my torch. 10 hours, 34 minutes. I'm planning on sleeping for 10 hours. So that should be pretty good. I know it's a little bit early, but I do need to sleep. Let's see where that puts us. It's not going to bring our rest all the way up. Should be close. Fire's still going. Have an hour and 6 minutes. Drink. Just go out here and see what the temperature is. I do plan on, if it's not too awful cold. Okay. We've got one down. So I think I should be okay to sleep a couple of more hours. Let it get full daylight. And the fire will go out. forgot about the coal. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw that on. I don't plan on coming back up here again. So 3 hours, 9 minutes. I can sleep for another 2 hours. If I get as much energy up as I can. But I don't plan on coming back up here again. So I really don't need to stockpile any more wood or anything. Pick that up. And I want to take this with me. Because I want to do another wolf coat. And can you make anything else out of wolf other than a coat? So deer, moose, rabbit, wolf skin coat. I guess that's all you can make out of wolf skin. Here. And we'll go down to wolfskin. That would show everything in all of the menus. Yep, just a wolfskin coat. But I do want to keep some wolfskins available in case I get attacked and I need repairs on my coat. So it's at 94%. And look at our weight. 74. Oh, good. 74 pounds out of 88. That moose hide satchel really makes a difference. Which also means I can collect cattails. I didn't even look around when I walked out. Bears tend to sneak up on me. Not a good thing. And it will be good to get out of this area because this is really loud. I guess I've picked all the cattails here. Must have. Walk around this way just to be sure. I know I'm going to pass by the wolf that I killed. Yeah, plenty of cattails. Or not plenty, but there are cattails. I got all of those. Enough to keep me going for a little bit. And we will see if the wolf despawned. Because once he despawns, I believe a new wolf is not that far away. Right now, I've kind of enjoyed not having any wolves around. I do not need the heads. I've got a few of those. I just need the good eating part. I've never had a cattail stalk in real life. But I've heard for years that you could actually eat them. I've just never had any desire to. And as they say in a disclaimer here, do not try what you learn in the long dark in real life.
Think about his food.
Okay, squat down just in case. And we're gonna go over here and we'll eat some of these. Just so I don't accidentally lose the bonus by not paying attention. And it'll reduce my weight so I can carry more. And I will save 7 because that can get me 9 hours of sleep. If I am starving. I think there was some more over here that I didn't pick. Yep, couple there. And also collect these because we're moving into another area. I don't know what is in that area. There might be wolves and I don't want to have a bunch of wolf meat on me. Just in case there might be wolves or a bear there. Okay. If I need to go this way. Let's come up. No, I think it's this way. Yeah, that's why I need maps. Because I can read a map. I have a map of an area, I can find my way around, which seems to have, it's now a forgotten skill. People don't use maps anymore. Everything is on their phone with their GPS. But a GPS will not help you in a situation like this. One of the things I was really good at in the Army is map reading and land navigation. I really enjoyed that, being able to, having the ability to have a map in your hands. And I think the other way was the right way. That doesn't matter. I do need to get across here. But being able to have a map in your hands and simple tools like a compass, being able to determine exactly where you were on the map, once you know where you're at, you can find the direction you need to go in. I thought I could get down here. Okay, so I can't get down there. I have to go back across and go down that way. And I blame the fact that I'm getting lost on Henderland Games. It's all their fault. Because they've made the game so pleasing to the eye that I want to look around and look at things and I'm not really paying attention to where I'm going. I know that's not the way. I've got to go down the chute here. Or down this waterfall. And I probably can't get down here. I don't know if you can climb down this one. Oh, you should be able to. Just have to do it slowly. Yeah, there's where I went up and around. It's fairly windy. It's fairly cold. So I may at some point have to build a fire to warm up. Did I keep sticks on me? No, I burned them all. And I have not picked up any. So I believe once I get down here a little bit, I am going to build me a fire to warm back up. In 45 minutes. I should not freeze by then. Oh, now it's getting warmer. Okay, kind of figured it would do that. So we're about at our point where we were earlier in the video. We're exploring something new. I am warming up, so that's a good thing. I'm going to keep the firewood on me though. Pick up a couple of sticks if I can find them. Should be able to pick some up over there. I could make sticks out of that. That's going to put me really heavy, and then I'd have to drop them, and it's going to take time to pick them, or time to chop them down. So I should be able to find sticks over here. Okay, got two logs to cross. Ooh, got a cave. An ice cave. I was wondering, can you map caves? Let's give it a try. Nope, cannot map indoors. Okay, so here's another stick. My stick. There's one. Let's explore out here first, and then we'll come into the ice cave. Because I hear the ice caves you can get in one area, and it'll take you to a totally different area. Can be like a shortcut. And maybe this actually, because we did not explore the cave that we were in. We set up our base, so maybe this leads there. We don't have any of our four-legged friends running around. This makes me nervous crossing these things. Now, I live and grew up in the woods, and I've always been surrounded by mountains and woods. And I have crossed logs like that before and had them break. Don't see anything. Need a good vantage point here. I should have picked up charcoal, I didn't think of it. So we still have a dark area over here. And it is near our cave. The other cave didn't show up. And so we're going back into it. Explore over here a little bit. Looking to see if they map again. So I am around in here. It looks like I should be able to get back to our cave from here. Is that our cave? No, that's the one up at, that's the one at the lake over here. So that's the other cave that I found. That's the ice cave where we have our stuff. So it looks like in map reading, if you see something like this and you don't see any breaks in it, it means you can't get up it. But it looks like I should be able to walk around it and head back to our cave. Over here, look at this other side. a sapling here. Out that way. So is this the Hush River? I'm thinking it is. There's work. Now I am thinking that might be the rope near our cave. I'm gonna go find out. I'm gonna go ahead and walk around here. And see if our cave is nearby. Because that would be a much easier trek to go up this way than to climb the rope. Get to the signal fire. Provided they have given us a way down. Looks like they have. Just gonna be very, very cautious. We know there are wolves over here. And I know they have respawned. Could that be... that might be our cave over there. I think it is. So I think this is our cave, which means the way that I just came down is much easier than climbing the rope. So if it is our cave, I see a flare. Go to the next flare and turn right. And it is. Get rid of some of the... rifles. I'm sitting there thinking, yeah, three rifles is what I should have. So I'm gonna drop that. And we're gonna have a lot of stuff carried back. We have to might have to make a couple of trips. Did not leave any food here. So left some in here. And very little bit. But we do have cattails. 14 of them. I've got water. I've got wood. I got all my stuff now. Drop these wolf hides. And go ahead and drop that. I don't think that. Alright, so we are in a good spot here. I know where two ice caves are. So I believe in the next episode we are going to explore ice caves and see what that's all about. I will have to go out and get a deer or get a wolf because I am going to need the meat. But I see my timer up in the upper left hand corner says that it's been 60 minutes. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to end the episode. And in the next episode, which will be 25, we're going to explore the ice caves and get us some meat. So I will see you in the next episode. And until then, have a good one.